In this quick overview, we're going to take a look at the build section of Digibee. Now, you'll recall that Digibee is comprised of the build, run, and monitor sections. And inside the build area is where we're going to construct our pipelines, build new revisions or new versions of them. And you'll see over on the left-hand side that we can logically organize these into different projects so that we can group them together if they're serving maybe a common use case or business function. Before we drill in, we can see what version number the build one is currently on versus what's running in production. So we can see, for example, that there is a new version of in build here that's being worked on 1.3, whereas the production running version is 1.2. So we can absolutely make changes here without impacting production until we go and actually run and deploy, which we'll see in another video. So let's go ahead and drill into our main registration pipeline and take a look at how we build these out. Here we have the pipeline canvas where we're able to drag and drop the different components from the right-hand side over here. And this is what's going to allow us to consume data from any source, allow us to transform that data as needed, and then make any additional API calls to other systems in order to perhaps enrich that data. Now, every pipeline always starts with a trigger. So over here on the left-hand side, in this case, we have this set up as a REST API. If I click on the settings, we can see what methods are supported. We can see some of the different configuration options that are available to us in terms of what we're passing in and how we're spinning up this web service. Digibee supports a wide variety of different inbound API calls, or we can also be set to be an active schedule where a pipeline is simply run on a regular basis, either with a custom scheduler or some common times that we have examples of right here. But you'll also see support for things like HTTP file, email, different message systems like Kafka and Rabbit and Queue. Once we have the trigger configured, it's really about then how do we want to manipulate that data in order to get our desired output or build that final payload? In this particular example, we're looking to register a user. And so the API call that's going to arrive is going to be a payload describing that user that's signing up for our service. In Digibee, we make it very easy to test your configuration with this test button down here, where I can put in a sample payload that I'm expecting to receive. We have one here over on the left-hand side, and I can hit the play button and have it run through and show me my final output, but also each of the steps along the path. So when I click over to the messages tab here, we can see that the data arrives. Here's our input, and it gets validated. And then the first step that we're going to go through is to rename that input object. So we can see this JSON right here corresponds with this yellow icon right here. So we're following these along each of the steps. And the key with Digibee is we make things easy by everything that arrives in the system is converted to JSON. In this case, it happened to already be JSON, but each icon you're seeing, each component on the screen is simply passing JSON that it's either being manipulated or validated or some functions being performed against it. And it's just passing that JSON on to the next step. So in this particular example, what arrived was formatted as an API call coming in with method and post and body. And then we're renaming that. We wanted to call that input. So we've used this step to rename the JSON to be an input in this case. From there, we want to formulate that into XML because we're going to make an API call out. So as I scroll over to the right here, you'll see that we're starting to prepare in JSON initially what that XML is going to look like before finally handing that off to an XML query builder here, which is a step that's going to allow us to prepare that XML and then make ultimately a SOAP call out to a third-party service. So it's very easy to troubleshoot using this testing capability and rapidly iterate on your design. And it's also very easy to check at each step along the path, do I have the right data that I'm expecting as I'm building this process out? From there, we're going to take that XML, turn it back into JSON, the XML we get back from that API call out to that SOAP service. And then we're going to validate the information that came back, make sure we got the information we were looking for before storing that in our database and proceeding on with this user registration. Now, another thing that's unique about the Digibee platform is we make it really, really easy to what we call mock out different APIs. So let's imagine for a moment that I didn't have this endpoint available yet. Maybe it's still under construction. Maybe I'm in a test environment and I can't hit the production endpoint. But I know that the response back to it is going to look like this particular payload we have in this method. So if I had this data available to me, and again, a lot of times we'll have that. We'll say, hey, this is the payload we're expecting back from this API. What we can do is simply mock that up using a JSON generator. And this step just allows me to put in what's the JSON that you want to have happen at this moment within the pipeline. And so we're going to say simulate response from USPS API. This is just a simple zip code lookup. Or maybe during testing, I don't want to hit the production system because I don't want to be sending all the same duplicate information into a system over and over and over again. So I could pull that out temporarily and still be able to run through this pipeline, hitting the play button here, and it's still going to work. And as we scroll over here, we see that we have this new step showing in our message log here that shows, hey, we were able to simulate that, and it's going to have the same API call response, the same JSON, and we can proceed onwards as normal. So it makes it really rapid for testing and allows you to simulate endpoints very easily. And while in this case, it happened to be a SOAP call, of course, if it was a REST call, it's also very easy to drag and drop those components. And maybe they come out with a new version. It's gone from XML, and now we're going to use REST. So we can just put in the right URL here and build out what are the necessary query parameters to make that REST call to that new endpoint. So really easy to iterate on these and kind of integrate this in with that CI/CD pipeline.